हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन फर्स्ट वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स एंड फ्लूइड मशीन्स। आफ्टर वॉचिंग दिस लेक्चर यू शुड बी एबल टू फर्स्ट आइडेंटिफाई द डिफरेंट स्टेट ऑफ मैटर, सेकंड डिफाइन ए फ्लूइड एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ फ्लूइड, थर्ड अप्लाई न्यूटन्स लॉ ऑफ विस्कोसिटी। नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट। What is fluid and non-fluid? There are two states of matter, fluid and non-fluid. The fluid refers to liquid, vapor or gases phases, and non-fluid states means only the solid phase of matter. Now, this is fluid. A fluid is a substance which deforms continuously when subjected to shear force. The tendency of continuous deformation of substance is called fluidity. And a solid is a substance which deforms not continuously when subjected to shear force, or the tendency to resist deformation. Now, fluid mechanics. The subject of fluid mechanics deals with the study of motion and general behavior of a fluid governed by the law of conservation of mass, laws of mechanics, and laws of thermodynamics. Now, fluid mechanics, it is divided in three parts: fluid statics, fluid kinematics, and fluid dynamics. The study of fluid at rest is called fluid statics. The study of fluid in motion, where pressure forces are not considered, is called fluid kinematics. The study of fluid in motion, where pressure forces are not considered, is called fluid dynamics. Now, properties of fluid. Now, first property, density or mass density, it is denoted by rho. Now, density or mass density of a fluid is defined as the ratio of the mass of fluid to its volume. The unit of mass density in SI unit is kg per meter cube. Mathematically, rho equal to mass of fluid upon volume of fluid is m by v, kg per meter cube. The value of density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube or 1 gram per centimeter cube. The next property, specific weight or weight density, it is denoted by a symbol small w. Specific weight or weight density of fluid is the ratio between weight of fluid to its volume. Mathematically, W equal to weight of fluid divided by volume of fluid. Now, this is equal to mass of fluid into acceleration due to gravity divided by volume of fluid, or small w equal to m by v into g, and this is equal to rho g. So specific weight w equal to rho into g. The value of specific weight our weight density for water is 9.81 into 10 raised to power 3 Newton per meter cube. Now, next property, specific volume. Specific volume of fluid is defined as the volume of fluid occupied by a unit mass, or volume per unit mass of fluid is called specific volume. So, specific volume equal to volume of fluid divided by mass of fluid, or this is equal to 1 upon rho. The specific volume is the reciprocal of mass density, and the unit of specific volume is meter cube per kg. Now, next property, specific gravity. Specific gravity is defined as the ratio of weight density of a fluid to weight density of standard fluid. For liquids, the standard fluid is taken water, and for gases, standard fluid is taken air. Specific gravity is also called relative density. It is dimensionless quantity, and the symbol of specific gravity is S. Now, next important property, viscosity. Viscosity is defined as the property of fluid which offers resistance to the movement of one layer of fluid over another adjacent layer of fluid. When two layers of fluid at distance dy move over one over other at different velocity, we can say u and u plus du. The viscosity together with relative velocity causes a shear stress acting between the fluid layers. This is the graph between vertical means y, horizontal axis velocity. So two layers at distance y and dy, the velocity u and u plus du, then relative velocity, it is du, and distance between layers dy. Then the shear stress is proportional to the rate of change of velocity with respect to y, and the shear stress is proportional to du upon dy, or shear stress equal to mu into du upon dy, where mu is a constant of proportionality and is known as the coefficient of dynamic viscosity. So, du upon dy represents the rate of shear strain or rate of shear deformation or velocity gradient. Then mu, viscosity, this is equal to shear stress upon du upon dy. Therefore, the viscosity is also defined as the shear stress required to produce unit rate of shear स्ट्रेन, द यूनिट ऑफ विस्कोसिटी, देन म्यू इक्वल टू शियर स्ट्रेस डिवाइडेड बाय डी यू अपॉन डी वाई, द यूनिट ऑफ शियर स्ट्रेस न्यूटन पर मीटर स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय मीटर पर सेकेंड डिवाइडेड बाय मीटर, देन वी गेट न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर मीटर स्क्वायर। तो ऐसा यूनिट ऑफ विस्कोसिटी इट इज न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर स्क्वायर। द यूनिट ऑफ विस्कोसिटी इन सीजीएस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड पॉइस विच इज इक्वल टू डायन सेकेंड पर सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर, मीन्स वन पॉइस इक्वल टू वन डायन सेकेंड पर सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर। एंड रिलेशन बिटवीन पॉइस एंड न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर स्क्वायर, तो वन न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 10^5 डाइन डिवाइडेड बाय 10^4 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर, एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू 10 डाइन सेकेंड पर सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर, आर 1 न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर स्क्वायर इक्वल टू 10 पॉइस। नाउ नेक्स्ट काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी, इट इज डिफाइंड एज द रेशियो बिटवीन डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी एंड डेंसिटी ऑफ फ्लूइड, इट इज डिनोटेड बाय ए सिंबल न्यू, आर न्यू इक्वल टू डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी डिवाइडेड बाय डेंसिटी, आर म्यू अपॉन रो। नाउ यूनिट ऑफ काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी, देन यूनिट ऑफ डायनेमिक विस्कोसिटी न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय केजी पर मीटर क्यूब, एंड दिस इज इक्वल टू न्यूटन केजी मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय मीटर स्क्वायर एंड डिवाइडेड बाय केजी पर मीटर क्यूब। By simplifying, we get meter square per second. Then SI unit of kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. Now, in CGS unit, the kinematic viscosity is also known as stock. And one stock equal to 1 cm² per second. Then 1 m² per second equal to 100 × 100 cm² per second, or 10^4 cm² per second. Now, next topic, Newton's law of viscosity. It states that the shear stress tau on fluid element layer is directly proportional to the rate of shear strain. The constant of proportionality is called coefficient of viscosity, or mathematically it can be expressed as shear stress equal to mu into du upon dy. Fluid which obey the above relation are known as Newtonian fluid, and fluid which do not obey the above relation is called non-Newtonian fluid. Now, temperature affects the viscosity. द विस्कोसिटी ऑफ लिक्विड डिक्रीजेज विथ इंक्रीज ऑफ टेम्परेचर वाइल विस्कोसिटी ऑफ गैसेज इंक्रीजेज विथ इंक्रीज द टेम्परेचर. फॉर लिक्विड म्यू इक्वल टू म्यू जीरो वन अपॉन वन प्लस अल्फा टी प्लस बीटा टी स्क्वायर एंड फॉर गैसेज म्यू इक्वल टू म्यू जीरो प्लस अल्फा टी माइनस बीटा टी स्क्वायर. म्यू जीरो दिस इज द विस्कोसिटी एट टेम्परेचर 0 degree centigrade इन पॉइज. नेक्स्ट नाउ टाइप ऑफ फ्लूड्स. द फ्लूड मे बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू द फॉलोइंग. फर्स्ट आइडियल फ्लूड, सेकंड रियल फ्लूड, थर्ड न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड, फोर्थ नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड एंड फिफ्थ आइडियल प्लास्टिक फ्लूड. नाउ फर्स्ट आइडियल फ्लूड, ए फ्लूड विच इज इनकम्प्रेसिबल एंड इज हैविंग नो विस्कोसिटी इज नोन एज एन आइडियल फ्लूड. आइडियल फ्लूड इज ओनली एन इमेजिनरी फ्लूड एज ऑल द फ्लूड विच एग्जिस्ट हैव सेम सम विस्कोसिटी. सेकेंड रियल फ्लूड, ए फ्लूड विच पोसेसेस विस्कोसिटी इज नोन एज रियल फ्लूड. ऑल फ्लूड्स इन एक्चुअल प्रैक्टिस आर रियल फ्लूड्स. थर्ड न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड, ए रियल फ्लूड इन विच द शियर स्ट्रेस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू रेट ऑफ शियर स्ट्रेन आर वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट इज नोन एज न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. फोर्थ नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड, ए रियल फ्लूड इन विच द शियर स्ट्रेस इज नॉट प्रोपोर्शनल टू रेट ऑफ शियर स्ट्रेन नॉन एज नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. एंड फिफ्थ आइडियल प्लास्टिक फ्लूड, ए फ्लूड इन विच शियर स्ट्रेस इज मोर देन द यील्ड वैल्यू एंड शियर स्ट्रेस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू रेट ऑफ शियर स्ट्रेन इज नॉन एज आइडियल प्लास्टिक फ्लूड. नाउ ऑन ग्राफ द वर्टिकल एक्सिस शियर स्ट्रेस, हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट डी यू अपॉन डी वाई. वेर म्यू इक्वल टू जीरो आर विस्कोसिटी जीरो, तो दिस लाइन दिस इज आइडियल फ्लूड एंड शियर स्ट्रेस इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू डी यू अपॉन डी वाई, तो दिस इज न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड. एंड दिस कर्व विच नॉट ओबे द न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड मीन्स टॉ इज नॉट प्रोपोर्शनल टू डी यू अपॉन डी वाई, देन दिस कर्व इज फॉर नॉन न्यूटोनियन फ्लूड एंड दिस इज आइडियल प्लास्टिक. एंड द वर्टिकल एक्सिस मीन्स द वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट जीरो इन सॉलिड, तो दिस इज आइडियल सॉलिड. नाउ नेक्स्ट सरफेस टेंशन. सरफेस टेंशन इज डिफाइंड एज द टेंसाइल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन सरफेस ऑफ लिक्विड इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ अ गैस आर ऑन द सरफेस बिटवीन टू इमिसिबल लिक्विड सच दैट द कॉन्टैक्ट सरफेस बिहेव लाइक ए मेम्ब्रेन अंडर टेंशन. द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस फोर्स पर यूनिट लेंथ ऑफ द फ्री सरफेस विल हैव द सेम वैल्यू एज द सरफेस एनर्जी पर यूनिट एरिया. Now it is denoted by sigma and unit of surface tension sigma is newton per meter. Now surface tension on liquid droplet. Now consider a small spherical droplet of liquid of radius r. Now let the droplet is cut into two halves. Now draw free body diagram of half droplet. The force acting, which are tensile force due to surface tension acting around the circumference of cut portion. The total force is sigma into circumference, means sigma into pi d, and due to surface tension force, the pressure difference or pressure force on the area, which is pi by 4 d square. This is equal to pressure force equal to p into pi by 4 d square. Now equating both the forces under equilibrium condition, p into pi by 4 d square equal to sigma into pi d. Then pressure difference p equal to 4 sigma by d. Now surface tension on hollow bubble. A hollow bubble like a soap bubble in air has two surfaces in contact with air, one inside and other outside. Therefore two surfaces are subjected to surface tension. Now we draw the free body diagram of bubble. So surface tension force which act on two layers vertically upward and on downside pressure force. Then upward force equal to downward force, means 2 into sigma into pi d equal to pressure difference p in square. Then p equal to 8 sigma divided by d. Now next, surface tension on a liquid jet. Now this is the liquid jet of diameter d and length l. Now cut it into two parts and we draw the free body diagram of liquid jet. Now the force due to surface tension, it is on outside surface, and pressure difference is p. Then force due to pressure is p into the area, projected area, l into d, and force due to surface tension sigma into 2l. Equating the forces, p into l into d equal to sigma into 2l, then p equal to 2 sigma l divided by ld, or 2 sigma by d. Now capillarity. The capillarity is defined as a phenomena of rise or fall of a liquid surface in a small tube relative to the adjacent general level of liquid when the tube is held vertically in liquid. The rise of liquid surface is known as capillary rise, while the fall of the liquid surface is known as capillary depression, and it is in mmR in centimeter. It depends on specific weight of liquid, diameter of tube, and surface tension of liquid. Now let's solve some problem. Write down problem 1. Electric wire is to be coated with varnish for insulation by drawing it through a circular die of 0.9 mm diameter. The wire diameter is 0.8 mm and it is centered in die. The varnish mu equal to 0.02 newton second per meter square completely fills the space between the wire and the die for the length of 20 mm. The wire is drawn through the die at a speed of 50 meter per second. See in the figure. Determine the force required to pull the wire. Now, the problem 1 is based on Newton's law of viscosity. Now, the force required
to pull the wire is F equal to tau into area, where shear stress tau equal to or viscous shear stress tau equal to mu into V by T, where T is the gap and area, this is equal to pi dl, then F equal to mu into V divided by T into pi dl. Now, substituting the value of given values of mu, V, T, D and L, mu equal to 0.02 Newton second per meter square and V equal to 50 meter per second and D equal to in meter 0.8 divided by 1000 meter and L equal to 20 upon 1000 meter and T equal to gap T equal to 0.1 upon 2 into 1000 in meter, because T means gap, which is equal to 0.9 minus 0.8 divided by 2 in mm. Now it is converted to meter. Now, solving above equation, we get by calculation, we get F equal to 1.005 Newton. So, this is the answer.
Now, next question, write down problem 2. A spherical water of surface tension 0.7 Newton per meter, droplet of 1.2 mm in diameter splits up in air into 64 smaller droplets of equal size. Determine work required in splitting of the droplet. Now, this problem is based on surface tension.
Work required in splitting droplets. Splitting the droplets, W equal to surface tension sigma multiplied by change in area. Delta A means increase in area, increase in surface area. Now, W, this is equal to sigma final area, which is equal to n number of droplets into 4 pi r square minus 4 pi capital R square, where r is the radius of small droplet. Then volume r, W equal to 4 pi sigma n into r square minus r square. Now volume of water remains same, then volume of water, this is equal to n divided by 4 pi, 4 by 3 pi r cube equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now r, 4 by 3 pi cancel out, then r equal to capital R divided by n 1 by 3, r divided by 64 power 1 by 3, and this is equal to r by 4. Now W, this is equal to 4 pi sigma n equal to 64 and r equal to r by 4 power square minus r square. By simplifying, this is equal to 12 pi sigma into r square. Now substituting the value of sigma and r, substituting given value, sigma equal to 0.7 newton per meter, and r equal to 0.6 by 1000 in meter. Now W equal to 12 pi 0.7 into 0.6 by 1000 whole square. Now solving, we get W equal to 9.5 into 10 to power minus 6 joule. So this is the answer of this question. This is the answer.
Next questions, problem 3. A vertical shaft has a hemispherical bottom of radius of R, which rotates inside a bearing of identical shape at its end as shown in figure. An oil film of thickness T and viscosity mu is maintained in bearing. Determine torque required to rotate the shaft at constant velocity omega. Now this question is based on Newton's viscosity law. First we draw the diagram.
This is hemispherical bottom of shaft of radius R, and this is bearing of gap. This is bearing surface. This is a fluid or oil. Consider an element. This is the element of radius or at the radius R, and angular thickness d theta. This is theta. This is d theta. Radius is R. This is radius R. Then width is R d theta. this is r d theta, then vertical axis, this is vertical axis about which this rotate, then the radius of rotation of this element is r equal to r cos theta, small r depends on theta, then small r equal to r cos theta. Now the shear force on element due to viscosity df equal to top shear stress multiplied by area of element dA, and torque dT, this is due to shear force df multiplied by radius r. This is about vertical axis, which is equal to df into r, r df into small r equal to capital R cos theta, where df equal to tau into dA, and dt equal to tau into dA into r cos theta, where tau equal to mu into v by t, where v is the velocity of element, it vary with r, then mu into omega into r divided by t, and equal to mu w omega into capital R cos theta divided by t. So this is the shear stress, and area of element, this is circular element, width is rd theta and radius small r, then dA equal to 2 pi r into rd theta, this is the area of element because the element is circular of radius r, then 2 pi r cos theta into rd theta. So this is the area dA. Now dt equal to, put the value, tau equal to mu omega r cos theta by t, this is tau, and dA equal to 2 pi r cos theta into r d theta, this is the area dA, multiply by r cos theta, then this is dt. Now simplifying, dt equal to 2 into pi into mu into omega into r power 4 cos cube theta into d theta, t into d theta. So d depends on theta, other quantity which are constant, then t it depends on now theta. Now theta vary from 0 to pi by 2, then integrating this equation from 0 to pi by 2, then t or total torque means t equal to integration from 0 to pi by 2, 2 pi mu omega r power 4 cos cube or t cos cube theta into d theta. After solving above equation, we get t equal to 4 pi mu omega r power 4 divided by 3t, this is the torque t, and this is the answer of this question.
For more practice, please solve the questions given in assignment sheet. Write down. Any query, please write in comment box.